Now it is Salesforce Flowsome.
Hello, Flowsome people. Welcome to the Salesforce Flowsome channel. In this video, we will quickly go through what the Get Records element is. So let's drag a Get Records element onto your canvas. So after you specify the label, API name, and the description, the first thing to do is to specify which object you want to get. So even though it's saying object here, but you can actually search for objects, custom metadata type, custom settings, permissions, role, and so on. There's no documentation on what cannot be found here. So if you're unsure, simply open a new flow and test it out. But I haven't experienced not finding anything I need yet. Then you can specify the conditions to filter the results. You can use none, which means that it will get all the records. Or you can use all conditions, which is like the AND operator. Or any condition, which is the OR operator. Or you can have the custom logic, which will look like this. The next thing is to sort the records. I think this is really interesting. It will come really handy when you want to return the largest or the smallest based on the ascending or descending order. For example, if I want to get the largest customer account, I can do the descending order and then sort by the annual revenue. This will return the account that has the largest annual revenue. Or if you want to return the smallest company in terms of employee size, you can sort by the ascending order and then sort by number of employee. Not only can this get the largest or the smallest, you can also just arrange the records in a specific order before saving them into collections. Let's say if I want to return a list of accounts and I want to arrange them based on their creation date, I can choose all records and then ascending, sort by create date. This will return a list of accounts starting from the oldest all the way to the latest. Even though this can also be achieved by the collection sort element, by sorting your records right now, you get to save one element, so you don't need to create additional element to sort all your records. And then the next one is how many records to store. You can choose the first option, which will return a record single variable. Or if you want to return several records, you can choose the second one, which will return a record collection variable. Finally, how to store record data. I think this is the most confusing part. For automatically store all fields, Salesforce will actually only get the fields being used in the flow instead of all the fields. So for example, I have a flow here. And in this flow, I only use the account number and the account description. So when I run this flow, you will see the system is only getting the description, ID, and the account number fields. All other fields that I didn't use in this flow won't be queried by the system. There's only one exception though. When you pass the variable into a subflow, an action, or a lightning component, then the system will get all the fields. So let's look at this flow for example. In this subflow, I use the record variable returned from our getRecords element. So when I go ahead and run this flow, you will see the system is telling me that all the values are stored because I was using the variable in a subflow, action, or lightning component. However, not all the actions will grab all the fields though. It depends on what is the expected input. If an action is expecting a text input, then only the ID will be grabbed. If the action is expecting a record input, then all the fields will be stored automatically. You can always find out these details in the debug detail log. Then let's move on to the second option. Choose fields and let Salesforce do the rest. If you choose the first option, you don't have the control of which fields are being queried. So if you use it in the subflow, the system will just query all the fields, and that will be a big concern for the performance. Another scenario is that if you run the flow in the system contacts, your user might be able to access the fields that they don't supposed to have the permission. So if you are really concerned about the performance or the security, you can choose this option and to define what fields you want to get. This way, you will have the full control of what fields are being returned. Lastly, choose fields and assign variables. You should only use this when you want to either store the records in existing variables or store in a variable that allows for output. So let's look at an example. I have this main flow, which is getting an account record, and I use a subflow to get the contact record. And finally, I want the subflow to push back the contact record so I can see the contact information in this main flow. So when I look at the subflow, you can see I'm storing a contact in a variable that I created, which is available for output. So this way, when we are running the flow, you can see that the contact records is pushing back from the subflow. So let's say, if I go back and then choose the first option instead, and I will save the flow as a new version. And when I try to run this flow again, you will see now the contact record is not returned because the automatically created variable does not allow for output. Finally, quickly about these two options, where to store field values. You can either store all the values in a single record variable or in separate variables. And lastly, when no records are returned, set specific variables to null. For this option, originally it's designed to prevent the null pointer exception, but I believe this issue has been resolved properly after the API version 50, so I don't think the checkbox is that important anymore. However, it's always nice to have this checked as a reassurance. Finally, because get records is used to query data, so it will cost one SOQL query. If you enjoyed this video, like, subscribe, and turn on notification. Salesforce Flowsome, thank you for watching.